Hello and welcome to my review of Skellig by David Almond. Skellig was first published in 1998 and is narrated by a schoolboy called Michael. Michael's family have just moved into a rundown new house, and in the garage he finds a humanoid creature that later calls itself Skellig. Michael sneaks food out to Skellig and slowly his health improves. In the meantime, Michael's sister, who was born premature and is in a state of declining health herself, has to return to hospital for an operation. Michael is desperately concerned by the situation. His school attendance and effort declines, and he finds it harder to relate to his school friends. With the help of his homeschooled ornithologist neighbour Mina, he moves Skellig to an abandoned house nearby, where Skellig's health continues to improve further, even as Michael's sister's health declines. One of the better aspects of this novel is the characters. All of them feel quite real, including the tragic Ernie, who owned the house before they bought it, and died in it and has left his mark, such as moving the toilet into the kitchen because he was too frail to get to it otherwise. Working the day job I do and seeing this sort of thing quite regularly, it was pretty touching, and Ernie is not even in the book really, so this description of his grim final days really grounds the text very early. It feels very real. There is nothing held back or even sanitized, which you might have expected in a book predominantly aimed at children. I'm not a teenager, but I thought that Michael and Mina both worked quite well. Michael is compassionate and caring for both Skellig and his unnamed sister. Losing focus on his own things as their struggles and the physical relocation all distracts him. Mina is the wild embodiment of the call of youth and imagination, a book scribbling know-it-all in the best sense of that. A fairly familiar character these days, but pretty well done here in their burgeoning relationship. And the friction it causes Michael's usual social circle is convincing, fun, and interesting throughout. The tone of Michael's narration seems appropriate to the age, though younger readers would, of course, have a better take on this than me. Passages about Michael's football matches are probably the least convincing parts. In the yard that lunchtime, I played football as hard as I could. I did sliding tackles and diving headers. I dribbled and dummied and went for wild overhead kicks. I scored 4 goals, made 3 more, and my team won by miles. At the end, there was a long rip down the side of my jeans. The knuckles of my left hand were scratched and scraped. There was blood trickling from a little cut over my eye. If nothing else, I'm pretty sure that if you did all of that, then your friends would certainly consider you whatever the current slang is for a ball hog. Perhaps having ripped clothes and being bleeding might even get you sent home. Not only that, but I think that certain bits of this read more like a grown-up who is not a particularly big football fan writing rather than a young lad who is. It is, however, a smallish part, and it seems easily forgivable because the rest of the book is quite on the money. And it's interesting too that it's Mina, not Michael, that got another book. She is precocious, wise beyond her years, a sculptor, artist, and a William Blake aficionado. In modern times, this kind of infallible female character is of course ten a penny, but Almond's depiction of Mina keeps her largely sympathetic and often fun. And while she fits the current politics perfectly in that regard, it's also interesting to see that this book has been embraced so much by schools, when its most memorable character spends half the book quoting Blake and otherwise criticizing scholastic methods. School inhibits the natural curiosity, creativity, and intelligence of children. The mind needs to be opened out into the world, not shuttered down inside a gloomy classroom. Perhaps this perceived edginess helps the book appeal to more reluctant to read children, or maybe that's just what the curriculum setters hope. Mina and Michael's caring for the grumpy, reluctant Skellig comes with a moral of not judging a person by appearance, of helping those in need, even in times of your own need, and is heartwarming stuff, even if, again, it comes with a degree of familiarity being equal parts Stick of the Dump and E.T. Mina is, with her repeated quoting of William Blake, the embodiment of the other major theme of the book, the freedom and innocence of youth, with her homeschooling supposedly making her a freer, wiser, better person. Yet much of her knowledge is absorbed purely through Blake or her mother, at best a marginal upgrade on Michael's supposedly formulaic and stultifying schooling. Michael is at the crossroad in Ormond's eyes, the transition from child to adult. All around him are visions of death, whether it is his stricken sister, the remnants of Ernie's last days, the derelict home they've moved to, or the fledglings killed by the cat Whisper. The threat then is to his innocence. The difficult transition to the new home, the changes that has on his school experiences, and the painful arrival of his young sister into his life, all of these new encounters and events threaten to take him away from his true place. It's interesting too that Mina and the school both discuss with him the continuing process of evolution around him and including him. Change is a constant not to be feared, not to be rushed, And Skellig and Mina are the agents of restoration for all concerned, but particularly for giving him back his innocence, a sense of wonder, the loss of which would of course mean the premature and permanent end of his childhood. The entertaining leads, combined with the contrast of the spiritual Skellig with a more dark and grim Hobbesian sort of reality, they help this rise above its familiar tropes and go some way to explaining its enduring popularity. Skellig is a brief text, accessible and readable as you'd expect from a text aimed at the young end of the young adult market. It doesn't require a huge investment of your time and will repay it handsomely. This book is recommended. Thank you for watching, and if anything in this video has inspired you to click like or subscribe or ring the bell, then why not check out some of our other videos as well while you're here.